we're in Merrow, where we're meeting Surrey County Council and Kier, who've put together a highways supply chain alliance using the FAC-1 Framework Alliance Contract.
So the idea for Horizon started several years ago. We had some real challenges in Surrey with the condition of the roads, and we needed some investment. But the reality was we didn't have sufficient money to achieve the results we wanted. We felt we could do a lot if we brought the supply chain into the decision making and the design. We thought there were a lot of savings and efficiencies we could get out of it. So we started to work on supply chain with them at that stage. The results surprised us in terms of what we achieved. So the savings we got from the programme, about 15%, that enabled us to deliver a £120 million programme for £100 million. But in addition to that, other things that we weren't expecting came out of it as well. We saw more investment into apprenticeships and skills through the arrangements we put in place. We saw extended warranties. So instead of 2 to 4 year warranties on materials, we were getting up to 10 year warranties. And also what we saw and what the public really saw was improved quality of work. And we've seen increased customer satisfaction over the period of time with the programme, way beyond our expectations.
Why did Surrey choose to use FAC-1 on the new supply chain alliance with Kier?
So when we did Horizon, obviously there was no standard form available to use at the time. We were using a bespoke agreement, which worked very well, and obviously we'd tested how effective it was through Horizon. With the opportunity of FAC-1 then appearing ready for our next supply chain exercise, we thought it was very sensible to use a standard form of contract. And of course, because FAC-1 took into account the work we'd done with Horizon, we knew we could be confident that it was going to work with us for us and give us all the benefits we wanted.
We're going to see how the Supply Chain Alliance has worked out in practice for Surrey and for Kier and for Aggregate Industries as one of their subcontractors and suppliers.
We had some existing arrangements in terms of, I guess you would say, standard apprenticeship programs where we had a number of apprentices within Kier and within our subcontract supply chain. But we went beyond that to generate some sort of more visible and tangible benefits to the community. One example of where that's been really successful is a guy called Freddie Seal, who has now, I think, been with us 2 years, just over 2 years, and he's developed through from the S-Skills programme at Brooklands through to now being a valued member of the team here, and really pleased with that. And we're in the second year of it, about 30 people have gone through that programme, 30, 36 people. So makes a difference.
Well, key to integrated teams is that sort of feeling of that shared investment, breaking down barriers, building of trust. And so the FAC-1 has provided us with the structure and the environment to promote that integration by recognising the needs of each of those alliance members has been very helpful in facilitating that integrated team working.
And we also have quite a strict and structured governance process that is aligned to our contract. Therefore, we have weekly progress meetings, we have monthly contract meetings, and we have a joint core group with both Surrey and Kier.
What has been Aggregate Industries' experience of working in an FAC-1 alliance with Surrey and Kier?
Positive, very positive. The normal contracts we work in are very traditional, sort of freight or type contract. Whereas with the FAC-1 contract, it's very mature relationship we have with all parties, Surrey, Kier, and the other members of their supply chain too. So we can share best practice, whether that be health and safety, material types, through ECI, to deliver best value for the client and for us as well as the supply chain.
And what sort of improved value can AI bring to schemes as a result of early involvement through supply chain collaboration?
I think with AI, obviously, we're a national company and we've got a great R&D department as well. So we can look at bespoke materials. In the old contract, we had a 10-year warranty under the Horizon schemes. So we looked at a bespoke type of material that could fit the purpose. Alongside the materials, obviously, we invest a lot in health and safety. So we can share our innovations within health and safety to the other supply chain and to Kier and to Surrey that they can then pass on as well.
We saw over the period of Horizon that Surrey went from having the lowest levels of satisfaction in the country to getting to about the middle, which may not be too much to shout about, but was significant movement in terms of general satisfaction with how we were maintaining the network. But also what we were getting was a lot of letters of compliment, which we very rarely see. Over the period of the programme, in excess of 100 letters of compliment, because people could really see the improved quality of work that we were actually delivering. It was a different experience to them.
In terms of environmental benefits, have you had any impact there through Project Horizon and the New Alliance?
So what we've seen is the opportunity to actually view in advance what's coming up. So actually having 5 years' work ahead of us, understanding what's involved in delivering that work, has enabled us to do things that we haven't been able to do in the past. For example, on Horizon, one of the problems we suffer with is a lot of our roads have tar in them. Tar is carcinogenic, is expensive to deal with. Through Horizon, because we knew how much tar we were going to have to deal with, Kier were able to actually develop solutions which enable us to deal with it in a far more sustainable way. We can now turn it into a product which is usable. Environmentally, it's much better. Financially, it's much better. And those are the kind of benefits you can get.
Will Surrey use alliances under FAC-1 on other programmes, other procurements?
I'm really keen that we roll it out. I think the success we've had with FAC-1, the real tangible benefits that have been delivered through the things that have been created are, you know, indisputable. There's lots of evidence for them. I think there's a really compelling case that we use it. Certainly for me, for the areas I look after under highways, you know, FAC-1 for me is now our preferred route. We're going to start to explore it on property, and colleagues in procurement who are involved in that side will be looking at it as well. I think it's proven what it can actually achieve, and the improvements you can get if you have effective supply chains facilitated by the use of FAC-1, I say, is unarguable benefits.